All right, it is time for 4 minute abs with Lauren. Go ahead, all the way down on your back. Now we're building on from last week's 4 minute abs. 7 o'clock, you are on your back. On mat, yoga mat, gym mat, doesn't really matter. Hands under your head. And all you've got right now is just regular old crunches. Let's see it. So remember, last week we talked about anchoring our pelvis. We want to make sure we're not pulling up using our hip flexors. Relax those legs. Don't use them to pull. Don't use the weight of your feet to counterbalance either. That's also called cheating. All right, so we're lifting our shoulder blades off the ground as high as you can. If you want to really challenge yourself, lift your shoulder blades and your rib cage. There we go. All right, I saw a little bit of wiggling. See, try that again without the wiggling. Nice! That was awesome. Exactly. So it is. It's much harder to do it that way, to use your abdomen only instead of counterbalancing and using the legs to pull. All right, you've only got 10 more seconds. You're doing a great job. And if you remember, what we did last week is we took this leg, put it on top of the other one, forehead to the knee. All right, let's see it. Now, before she even gets started, what's gonna happen is both ends are gonna come up and come together. Ready?
Okay.
So, her knee goes right to her forehead. She's knocking herself out. Lower body comes off the ground. So we've got a reverse curl going on at the bottom, and we have a crunch going on at the top. And she's got it perfect. Can you feel the difference between last week and this week?
Yeah.
All right, we're halfway there, and she's doing a fantastic job. I have no complaints.
Great.
I'm not gonna make you redo it.
Okay.
Perfect. So we're almost there. We've got 20 seconds left. That's about 10 more crunches. You got it. Beautiful. Okay, let's do 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 more, one more. There you go. Now, feet side by side, and now we're gonna return to the crunches we did at the beginning. Just straight up, straight down, and again, focusing on what?
Pelvis.
Anchoring the pelvis. Perfect. Lifting that shoulder blade nice and high off the ground. It should be super challenging right now, lifting up the rib cage. And as long as you've got those shoulder blades, I know you're working hard. All right, we've got less than 30 seconds, so we're more than halfway through. Doing perfect. Good. Also, notice her eyesight, how it goes in the direction she's going. She's not looking up to the sky. She's not allowing her sight to stay focused as her ribcage moves forward. Horrible on the neck. Just keep the ears in line with the shoulders as you come up. Your eyesight also line travels. All right, so now we're going on to the next leg. It's gonna go right up on top, the knee is center. Now remember, she's gonna lift both ends up. You got it. Both ends up. Are you excited for the progression for next week, Lauren?
Very.
This is just baby steps, stepping stones. Next week's gonna be so much more fun. Keep that knee center, up and down, but I promise, you'll love it. All right, only 30 seconds left. Perfect. Keeping that knee center, it's a little challenging towards the end because you're just so dang tired. And I totally understand that. Good. Shoulder blades, look how nice and high your shoulder blades are. Fantastic. All right, 10 seconds left. So that means we got about 5 more reps in there. 5, 4,